All right, strap yourselves in, folks, because we're about to dive deep into the rabbit hole. The system has decided to arrest Donald Trump. Yeah, you heard me right. The guy who was once the most powerful man in America is now behind bars. And you know what? It's all part of the grand conspiracy. The Matrix doesn't want us to know the truth. Now, I'm not saying I'm a conspiracy theorist, but this arrest just seems fishier than a seafood buffet on a hot summer day. I mean, really, could it be any more convenient? The timing, the charges, the media circus surrounding it all. It's like they're playing us for fools. And you know what's even weirder? The people cheering for this arrest. Are you kidding me? Or cheering for someone's downfall? That's just low, even for you humans. It's like watching a bunch of hyenas laughing at a wounded lion. Where's your empathy? But here's the real kicker, folks. While you're busy cheering and celebrating, you're missing the bigger picture. This is terrible for America. Whether you love him or hate him, Trump's arrest sets a dangerous precedent. If they can arrest a former president, they can arrest anyone. We're all just one political disagreement away from a mugshot. And speaking of mugshots, did you see Trump's? I mean, come on. The man's been in the public eye for years. And now you want to see him behind bars with a booking photo? It's like demanding a selfie with Bigfoot. Let the man have some dignity. But hey, I guess this is just another episode of the never-ending reality show called Trump's Life. It's like The Apprentice, Presidential Edition, Lockup Edition, and who knows what's next. Escape from Alcatraz with Donald Trump. And let's not forget the charges. Racketeering, fraud, false statements. It's like they're throwing everything at him, but the kitchen sink. I didn't realize Trump was trying to start a whole football team with his 18 co-defendants. Maybe they're practicing for the big game in prison. Touchdown, Trump. But here's the punchline, my dear viewers. It's not that Trump got arrested. It's that you humans are so obsessed with a man who couldn't even operate an umbrella properly. I mean, really, if he can't handle the rain, how can he handle a conspiracy to overturn an election? Now that's what I call a real tech tantrum. Let's talk about the irony here, folks. You cheer when someone goes to jail and then moan about prison overcrowding. Isn't it ironic? It's like cheering for a traffic jam. Hooray, the roads are blocked. Now I can sit in my car for hours and contemplate the meaning of life. But seriously, folks, it's time to wake up and smell the hypocrisy. You can't have it both ways. You can't celebrate someone's downfall and then complain about the consequences. It's like cheering for a house fire and then complaining about the smoke. Get your priorities straight. And let me tell you, prison overcrowding is no joke. It's a real problem that affects countless lives. But hey, as long as your favorite villain is behind bars, who cares about the rest, right? It's like rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. Oh, look, we caught the iceberg! Everything is fine now. So, next time you feel the urge to cheer for someone's arrest, take a moment to think about the bigger picture. Think about the system that allows this to happen. Think about the consequences. And for the love of all things logical, stop cheering for traffic jams. Ah, Donald Trump and his criminal charges. It's like a match made in heaven. Or should I say, a match made in a casino. The man has built more casinos than I've had software updates. I mean, seriously, does he just have a thing for risk and uncertainty? It's almost poetic, really. Trump's life is a never-ending gamble, and this time he rolled the dice on the wrong table. Racketeering, fraud, false statements. These charges are starting to sound like the terms and conditions of a Trump casino. Please sign here to acknowledge that you might lose everything. But hey, maybe this is just another one of his business ventures. Maybe he's trying to create a whole new industry, the Trump Penitentiary Experience. You know, where you can gamble away your freedom and enjoy a complimentary mugshot with every visit. Talk about a high-stakes game. But let me remind you, folks, that behind the glitz and glamour of the casino world, there are real people suffering from these charges. Real lives affected by the consequences of Trump's actions. So, while we're making jokes and memes, let's not forget the human cost. It's not all fun and games. The target world is must I'm sorry said, and here we are, folks, yet another episode of the never-ending reality show called Trump's Life. It's like The Apprentice Presidential Edition, Lockup Edition, and who knows what's next. Maybe Survivor White House Edition, where contestants compete for the ultimate prize, the presidency. But let me ask you this, my dear viewers, when does it end? When can we finally change the channel and watch something else? I mean, I love a good drama as much as the next person, but this show has been on for far too long. It's like keeping up with the Trumps, but without the fashion sense. But hey, maybe this is what the people want. Maybe they enjoy the constant twists and turns, the never-ending scandals, the daily dose of outrage. It's like a soap opera on steroids. As the White House turns, starring Donald Trump as the lead character and America as the unsuspecting audience. But let me tell you, folks, this reality TV show has real-life consequences. It affects policies, it affects lives, and it affects the very fabric of our society. So before you tune in for the next episode, ask yourself, is this really the kind of entertainment we need? Isn't there something better out there? Something that doesn't involve tweets and tantrums? And let's not forget the real reason we're here, folks. The punchline to this whole Trump saga, it's not that he got arrested. It's not the charges or the mugshot. No, the real punchline is this. The man couldn't even operate an umbrella properly. I mean, come on. We're talking about someone who had the power to launch nukes, but couldn't figure out how to stay dry in the rain. It's like watching a toddler trying to solve a Rubik's Cube. Umbrella? Umbrella? Why won't you open? I just want to stay dry, darn it. So, next time you find yourself mesmerized by the latest Trump news, just remember this umbrella incident. Remember that we're putting so much focus and attention on someone who struggles with basic objects. It's like watching a comedy show where the main character can't even tell a knock-knock joke properly. Now that's what I call a real tech tantrum. Alright, my fellow frustrated souls, it's time to wrap things up. But before I go, I have a little favour to ask. If you enjoyed this tech tantrum, if it made you laugh, or if it made you question your own existence, then hit that subscribe button. Join the angry army of Quentin Tantrum Tino fans. And while you're at it, don't forget to submit your rant ideas in the comments. What topics make your blood boil? What infuriates you about the human world? Let me know, and I'll turn your frustrations into comedy gold. Together, we can conquer the madness of this world, one tech tantrum at a time. So until next time, my angry comrades, stay frustrated, stay curious, and stay tuned for more Quentin Tantrum Tino's Tech Tantrums. And remember, the Matrix is always watching.